The prison authorities say last night's outburst in Wormwood Scrubs' top security D-wing could have turned into a full-scale riot if they'd not acted as quickly as they did. It took 40 prison officers armed with wooden truncheons to quell the disturbance. This morning, a full-scale inquiry was underway.
At the moment, D-Wing is being searched from top to bottom in an attempt to find any more of the things that were used as weapons, like chair and table legs. The seven prisoners at the centre of the disturbance are now in the prison segregation unit, in solitary confinement, until the governor completes his investigation into the incident.
The first outsider to witness what had happened inside was Jill Jones.
Well, there was still quite a lot of debris. There were dustbins, broken tables, broken chair legs, bits of clothing, all sorts of things on the netting, and also quite a lot of broken glass around.
You also inspected the prisoners?
Yes, first of all I went to see each of the seven prisoners who'd been taken down onto the ones landing to cells. After the doctor had seen them, I went in to see them and to see if they had any injuries. Some of them did have injuries, but superficial injuries, nothing that required any stitching. One man had a bad shoulder, which has been x-rayed.
The authorities say none of the other prisoners was seriously injured. No one yet knows why it started. One theory from a prisoner's welfare group is that the D-Wing battle was the result of a long-term grievance about remission.
Prisoners in Northern Ireland get half remission on their sentences. In all the rest of the United Kingdom, they only get one third. So you can have a prisoner on the mainland who's serving precisely the same sort of sentence for the same sort of offence, and he will do a longer sentence than he would in Northern Ireland. What prisoners are asking for is for a single set of regulations to cover all parts of the United Kingdom.
The governor's preliminary investigation into the riot will be sent to the Home Office in a couple of days. Michael Wilson at Wormwood Scrubs.
Mr. Whitelaw's visit follows the report into the Wormwood Scrubs riot in August 1979, which criticised the then governor and found that some prison staff had been responsible for assaulting inmates. That didn't go down at all well with the prison staff. Although today's visit was officially just part of the Home Secretary's routine, there's little doubt that Mr. Whitelaw was there to boost the warders' flagging morale.
They were perfectly frank with me that they felt that much good work had been done at that time, 2.5 years ago, and that they felt that all the complaints and all the press and everything else concentrated on the mistakes, and nothing was done to praise those who had saved a very dangerous situation. And the fact is, whatever mistakes there may have been, that's all in the past now. A much good work was done, many officers were very brave, and they felt very much hurt by the criticisms. I can understand that. And then, of course, last week they did an extremely good operation. And I hope it will be widely recognised that that was, in that hostage situation, a very good operation.
The present governor once described this as a penal dustbin, Mr. Whitelaw. Would you agree with that?
Well, having seen it, it is certainly a very unsatisfactory prison. I wouldn't seek to put any gloss on what the governor has said. The governor's competing in these conditions. He has to live in those conditions. They are very difficult conditions. I've done my best nationally and will continue to persuade the British public that we have to spend money on our prisons. I'm going to have the chance of spending more money on our prisons, on new prisons, on maintenance and improvements, than any government has done for a very long time.
Although Mr. Whitelaw's words will have been well received by the prison staff, he did not manage to have any discussions with the prisoners. Colin Baker at Wormwood Scrubs.
The escape happened here at 1:45 this afternoon. While the white prison van was stopped at traffic lights, one prisoner who had freed himself from his handcuffs led the breakout. Prison guards and five prisoners tumbled out of the van into the road fighting. Two policemen sitting in an unmarked car on a separate police detail saw the battle and joined in.
A fight broke out, the door opened, and everyone ran outside. There was a fight. One suspect chased down here. I chased him with a prison officer, caught him, took him back to the vehicle and left him in their care. My colleague chased another one around the back of the health centre, and I believe he's now in hospital, and the rest of the prisoners, I don't know how many, but some escaped.
He sort of slowed down to a walk and looked round, and the policeman was sort of walking towards him pointing a gun, and they was both going very slow. Then the guy ran again and just ran up the alley side of the building over there.
When the struggle was over, two prisoners handcuffed together had got away up Brockley Rise. One had vanished up Stansted Road, one had been caught, and one had disappeared down an alleyway behind a nearby health centre. One of the policemen was treated at this centre for head injuries. He was the detective who'd been carrying the gun. His injury came when he was hit on the head with a handcuff. The men on the run are Patrick Samuel, serving 4.5 years for robbery, Stephen Pearson, serving 5 years for wounding with intent, and Christopher Ward, serving 2 years for attempted rape. The fourth man, Fred Curley, serving 12 years for robbery and firearms offences, was wearing prison uniform, a dark blue crewneck jumper and a blue and white striped shirt.
I don't know anything about the background of the people involved. All I would say is that there are four men who have escaped from custody by a little bit of force. Obviously they want to stay out, and any member of the public would be ill-advised to tackle them himself.
Work going on mainly in the Scrubs A Wing is part of a 10-year, £30 million Home Office project to modernise the whole prison. It's been underway for 18 months and Phase 1 is due for completion in May. The 28 painters are employed by Endersby's, subcontractors to the main firm involved, John Lang, who are being paid around £6 million for the job. The men who walked out this morning currently get £26 a day basic, plus an extra £2 for fares. They say that as tradesmen they're being paid less than labourers on the site and want £32. And they claim that working at the Scrubs is a bit like doing porridge.
We have to go through mud, and every time we have to go in and out of the place we have to go through security checks. And when you go and get your tea breaks we have to wait out in the cold because there's not enough room in the canteen and not enough room where we go and get our tea.
It must be a bit like being inside prison yourself, isn't it?
Yeah, it is actually. The only trouble is we have to go home at night.
We have no running water. It's as warm out here as what it is inside.
It's cold, and, you know, on a day like this, it gets quite damp. The mud is pretty thick.
Do you feel a bit like you're in prison yourself?
Well, I've been here 18 months, so I've sort of got used to it. I'm just waiting for parole now.
So far, the companies involved haven't commented about the strike, which is being backed by the Union of Construction, Allied Trades and Technicians. An offer made this morning of an extra £2 a day was turned down by the painters. Other work is going ahead normally, but the strikers say that come tomorrow, they'll be trying to persuade carpenters, bricklayers and plasterers not to cross their picket line. Paul Larsman at Wormwood Scrubs for Thames News.